two objects, both similar in size, but one is a powerful, glowing furnace, while the other is a planet quietly orbiting the Sun. That's the story of Jupiter and Proxima Centauri, the closest star to our solar system. Even though their volumes are nearly the same, one is a planet, and the other is a star. Not to mention there are a lot of stars smaller than Proxima, even smaller than Jupiter. But how can two objects that are similar in size have different identities? The answer lies in the following few minutes. Jupiter, the largest planet in our solar system, is a gas giant composed mostly of hydrogen and helium. With a diameter of about 143,000 kilometers, it is so large that more than 1,300 Earths could fit inside it. But despite its immense size, Jupiter never became a star. Why? Because it doesn't have enough mass. To become a star, an object must have enough mass to create the pressure and temperature at its core needed to ignite nuclear fusion. This process fuses hydrogen atoms into helium, releasing a massive amount of energy in the form of light and heat. Jupiter, with only 1/1000th the mass of the Sun, never had enough mass to trigger this process. It's estimated that Jupiter would need to be at least 70 times more massive to become a star. So, while Jupiter is large, it remains a planet, radiates only the heat left over from its formation, making it a cold and dark giant planet. Now let's turn our attention to Proxima Centauri, the closest star to our solar system. Proxima Centauri is a red dwarf, which is the most common type of star in the Milky Way. With a diameter of about 200,000 kilometers, Proxima is only 40% larger than Jupiter. However, its mass is approximately 128 Jupiters. Far higher than the 70 times Jupiter mass criteria. And because of this, Proxima Centauri shines as a star, albeit much dimmer than larger stars. So why similar sizes can cause so different masses? In Jupiter's case, as a gas giant, its immense size is determined by the balance of its mass and the pressure exerted by the gas, primarily hydrogen and helium, in its atmosphere. However, increasing mass beyond a certain point doesn't cause a planet to expand significantly. Instead, gravity compresses the material, preventing the object from getting much larger. For Proxima Centauri, a red dwarf star, despite having a mass about 128 times that of Jupiter, the same gravitational compression occurs, limiting its size. Red dwarf stars are also a dense type of stars because their smaller mass means that red dwarfs lack the radiation pressure to expand their outer layers significantly. So planets, no matter how they appear large, lack the necessary mass to ignite fusion. They may have similar sizes to stars, but without the energy source of nuclear fusion, they remain cold, dark objects that reflect light rather than emit it. Congratulations, you've received some more unuseful knowledge. Hi-fi.